Good morning. Today we study origin of Rajputs. The rise of Rajputs and the establishment of their kingdoms is an important event in the history of India. After the fall of Vardhan dynasty, there was a prolonged absence of a strong central power and the centripetal tendencies dominated the political horizon. Many republic nobles, foreign tribes like Indo-Greek, Shak, Kushan, Pahlav, Hun, Kshatriya and Brahmanas got involved in the process of carrying small independent kingdoms. The one that proved victorious in this political gamble were the Rajputs, who captured power and politically dominated different parts of the country from the 17th to 12th century AD. Hence, this period is known as the Rajput period in the history of India. The Rajput word is derivative of Sanskrit word Rajputra, meaning the son of the king. Its extensive uses can be found in the ancient text. Reference of Rajputra can be traced back to the Veda, Rigveda, Yajurved, where it is used as a synonym for Rajan, Rajanya, Kshatriya, those associated with battles, defense and administration. This term is also used in Arthashastra of Chanakya, drama of Kalidas, Harshcharitra and Kadambri of Banbhat. Even Huinsang, the Chinese traveler who visited India at the time of Harshvardhan, refers to the king as Kshatriya and Rajputra. Many texts and inscriptions of Rajput period bear the word Rajputra for Rajputs. A slight change in its meaning can be seen because it would not be specially mean a high political position but also denoted a particular dynastic group, the undercurrent of the elements of dynastic clan tradition seem to be existent. The word Rajput derives a caste reference from the arrival of the Muslims in India. Jagdish Singh Gehlot writes, till the invasion by the Muslims, the rulers were called Kshatriya. Later on, their power declined and they became feudal kings in place of sovereigns. Hence, during the Muslim rule, gradually the word Rajput came in practice to denote the caste of these rulers. The Rajputs are scarcely satisfied with discriminating their ancestor from the herd of mankind. Some plump themselves on a celestial origin, while others are content to be demi-celestial. This remarked Colonel James Todd. The issue of the origin of Rajputs remain unresolved and different scholars put up their views very differently. On the basis of various views, we can there are the five theories of origin of Rajputs. The first one is Vedic Kshatriya origin. The second one is Agnikund origin theory. Third one is Surya Chandravanshi origin. Fourth one is Brahmin origin theory. And the fifth one is theory of foreign invasion. We will study about the first theory, and which is Vedic Kshatriya origin. The divine theory can be traced from the ancient Indian scriptures and texts. This tradition seemed to be applicable on the Rajputs too. According to Manusmriti, Kshatriya originated from Brahma. From Rigveda Mandal 10 Purush Sukt, it is known that the Kshatriya were born from the arms of Brahma and the duty of defense of the other three Varnas was their task. After the 7th century, the Kshatriya were unable to perform this task well, but their association with Brahma gained importance. In order to re-establish the former glory of the Kshatriya rulers, the bards reaffirmed the divine origin principle in their poems and compositions. An inscription found at Nadharbharan bears the title Raghuvansh Krit. It seems that it was a deliberate attempt to establish a link of Rajput with Brahma and Krishna of the epic period. The next theory is theory of Agnikund origin. The fire pit origin finds earliest mention in the various Puranas, so as also in the 10th century work of Padamgupta Navsaha Sankh Charitra, and also an inscription of the 10th century of Agnikul chief discovered at Hotel in Nanded district in Maharashtra. According to Padamgupt, Parmar was born from the fire pit of Vashishta to rescue his Kamdhenu. This theory finds subsequent repetition in the Parmar inscription of 11th century. In Nanded inscription of Agnikul chief, the family of chief has been mentioned as Agnikul, Bhenikul, Pavkakul, etc. They owed their allegiance to King Someshwar I of the Chalukya of Kalyani. Their ancestor rescued the Kamdhenu of Rishi Agastase in the valley of Mount Kailash from some rulers. The Rishi produced a strong man after offering oblation to fire, who rescued his cow. This man is represented as the progenitor of the Agnikund dynasty. Chandrabardhan Prithviraj Rasu is the main exponent of this theory. He states that Rajput originated from Agnikund. He writes that some Rishi like Vishwamitra, Gautam and Agastase were conducting religious rituals on the Abu mountain, which was obstructed by the demons. Therefore, to kill these demons, Muni Vashishth produced three warriors from the Agnikund, namely Parmar, Chalukya and Pratihara. When these warriors were unsuccessful against the demons, then Vashishtha produced the fourth warrior, armed with weapons and named him Chauhan, who secured the blessing of goddess Ashapuri and was able to drive the demons away. In this way, four clans of Rajputs originated from these four warriors. The Bard, Charans and Bhards believed in the truth of this account and repeated it in their composition subsequently. There are a number of historians who doubt the historicity of this account and reject this theory. Some historians opine that those Kshatriya who had adopted Buddhism during ancient time entered into the folds of Hinduism by undergoing the fire purification ritual and came to be known as Agnivanshi. There is also a possibility of the tribals joining the Kshatriya Varna after fire purification at the Agnikund. There is a third possibility of the opening of the doors of Hindu religion for foreigners like Shakunas, Yuchi, etc., who had permanently settled in India after they were purified by the Yajna. On this basis, many foreign scholars have tried to prove that Rajputs were foreigners who underwent the fire purification and become a part of Vedic Kshatriya Varna. Then, the next is Surya and Chandravanshi origin. The Charans, while compiling the history of Rajput in the 10th century, have referred them to be Surya and Chandravanshi. It seems that in emulation of the divine origin theory, which has taken up by the rulers at different periods, the Rajputs too called themselves as descendant of Ram, which was subsequently accepted by the Charans to appease their patrons. Certain inscriptions of the 13th century also testifies to the Surya Chandravanshi Rajput. The Chittor inscription of 1274 and Ankleshwar inscription of 1285. In the inscription of 1230 in the Tejpal temple, King Dharmpal has been called a Suryavanshi. Also in the inscription of Harshana temple in Sikar district, the Chauhans are referred as Suryavanshi. This fact is further supported by our ancient texts. Vedvyas has mentioned the names of 57 kings of Suryavanshi from Suryaputra Vanshanath till Ram. Purana also throw light to this effect. From the Agni Puran, we get to know that the Rajputs were descendants of Chandra Vanshi, Krishna and Arjun, and Surya Vanshi, Ram and Lavkush. It is probably on this basis only that Sri Jagdish Singh Gehlot remarked present dynasties of Rajput are the descendant of Surya and Chandra. Then the next theory is origin theory. The earliest exponent of this theory was Dr. Bhandarkar. This theory gains credence from the fact that historically there have been Brahmin kings. Ravan was Brahmin and ruled Lanka. Brahmin have been revered by the Kshatriya kings. For instance, King Janak of Mithila and Dashrath of Ayodhya held Rishi Vishwamitra in great esteem. It is known that the Pratihara of Mandor were Brahmin. They were the descendant of Brahmin Harsharitra and Madra. The Pratihara of Abu were the descendant of Rishi Vashishta. Sometimes the ruler took up the gotra of their Purohit, Pingal Sutra Kriti. An ancient literary scripture states that the Rajputs were the descendant of Brahmins. Modern historian Dr. Gopinath Sharma states that the Gulats of Mewar, whose ancestors was Guhidat, was a Nagar Brahmin. Dr. G.H. Oja accepts the fact that Guhilots were the descendant of Guhidat, a Nagar Brahmin, in his commentary on Geet Govind. This theory is not accepted by historians like Dashrath Rama. Even the Rajputs reject it. The next is foreign origin theory. Many foreign tribes came to India at different time periods, settled down and became an integral part of Indian religion and culture. On this basis, certain historians have tried to prove that the Rajputs were foreigners. Colonel Jomstead states that the Rajputs are descendant of Shak and Scythian. Tode believes that foreigners like Greek Shak, Hun, Yuchi came from Central Asia, and so the Rajputs too were foreigners who came from Central Asia. He accepts the Ragnikund theory, and on this basis he tries to prove that Rajputs were foreigners who entered India around 6th century. When these invaders carved kingdom for themselves, then by the fire purification ritual they were accepted in the folds of Hinduism because they were warriors and administrators. They were classed as Kshatriya and known as Rajputs. V.A. Smith believes that Rajput appeared suddenly in the 8th-9th century, hence were the descendants of Hunas. He believed that the foreign Gujars conquered a tract of land and named in Gujarat. In the same way, when the rule of Huna came to an end, they styled themselves as Rajput. On this basis, Smith opines that the Huna particularly settled and flourished in Rajputana and Punjab, the area, and most of the Gujars. The Rajputs have never considered themselves foreigner and hence rejected. They traced lineage from Surya and Chandravanshi clans. It is faulty to compare the tradition and customs of Rajput to that of Shaka and Satyaya because they existed even prior to their arrival in India. The prevalence of the worship of Ashwamedh Yajna and worship of arms and weapons by the Kshatriya is testified from the epic.